We're heading into weekend event risk associated with Brexit that will more than likely result in some form of a gap open when markets open up on Monday. What hangs in the balance is a Parliament vote on a Brexit deal that Boris Johnson was finally able to secure with the EU. As we head into the weekend, the base case projects a closer margin than what Theresa May was able to secure with her deal, but a margin of defeat for Johnson nonetheless. In this scenario, the pound will likely see a significant gap open lower on Monday, though at the same time, we don't believe the downside will be as aggressive as what many might expect, given that there will still be room for all sides to continue to work towards a resolution. In the event that the base case plays out and the deal is rejected, Boris Johnson will be legally bound by the Benn Act to seek an extension from the EU. There are concerns Johnson will circumvent this obligation, though we still believe this won't be a move that triggers a disorderly Brexit tail risk event. With that said, we see the pound now very well supported against the US dollar into the 124 to 125 area, with the major pair already trading into a technical uptrend as per the daily Ichimoku indicator. Alternatively, should the Prime Minister manage to secure a victory with the deal getting approved, we believe the pound could open a good deal higher, with room for a quick and aggressive push towards a retest of the yearly high from March up around 133.80. Of course, even in this scenario, rallies could quickly fade as uncertainty around elections work their way into the mix. But overall, we continue to see the greater risk associated with the pound as being tilted to the top side, not downside, at this stage in the game, as we believe the currency stands to benefit from a further pricing out of downside risk associated with the unlikely result of a disorderly Brexit. That's all for now.